What's up, guys? It's your Motivational Gamer, and welcome to episode 5 of our ARK Let's Play. So you guys requested longer videos, so I guess 8 minutes is too short. No, I guess it's not numbers away anymore. Alright, so in episode 5, back in episode 4, I gave you guys a tour because I was trying to find a place to set up. So I decided basically to choose one of the most dangerous places in Valhalla. And that happens to be the desert island. So I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a tour of my humble abode. You got Primitive Plus. You got different structures here. So we have a large campfire here, a big campfire. All right. We have a preserving meat rack. So this thing here can double as a preserving bin, and you don't have to put anything in it for it to work because it just stays preserving. So it's like automatic fridge. However, you can throw spark powder and stuff in here. I'm pretty sure to make jerky if you guys want. I have a grill, so this is a new thing here, but I made it backwards. I love you too, baby. I wanted to make it so where, like, when I came out the door, like, you know, it's kind of like a pit, you know, where you chill, and you have your grill, you make your steaks. But genius over here, this guy right here, put it backwards. So once I get some more mats, because this thing is kind of expensive to make, I need to flip it around. But this thing is cool. So this works like a industrial grill on regular ARK and cooks everything in mass. Now, and if you guys will see here, I have fresh fat here, so animal fat. And what you do is you burn that to make oil in Primitive Plus. And it's awesome. So you use that oil to make, obviously jerky and stuff like that and other recipes, especially for those of you guys in ARK who like to cook. They have, for the Ingrams, they have like baking stations and, fruit presses and all kinds of stuff where you can make juice and cook food that actually boost stats that you can sell or trade to people that need your specialty. So that's something that you can look at. This is my humble abode. I got my little fridge here. I left a ton of oil and cooked meat because I was trying to make jerky, but this guy forgot to put spark powder because I didn't read it. So it was like spark powder. It says, store your perishables with spark powder or firewood to preserve. Use spark powder to make jerky. And I was like, yo, why did this thing make it jerky? And then I got to obviously fix this roof here because, you know, it's still under construction. My baby. Because brick is expensive. So, as we get in here, we got our table here. We got a store, our little bookshelf here. This is actually a storage. Stores 100 items. We have a mill. This is actually the new school mortar and pestle here. Grindstone to make weapons like battle axes and Viking axes or whatever that's called. Oh, are you guys matching outfit? It's cute. And then you got your forge here to forge weapon rack. I don't know what the deal is with this bed, but they made this for like a stuffed animal. But that's a bed. Don't ask me why. And of course they got the cauldron here, which I don't know how it works yet. But you know, I'm trying to get some jerky together, make some kibble. But I'll be doing a video showcasing some of the items here because there's a lot. Really a lot to take in Primitive Plus. Like, I really feel like ARK should have, honestly, the format that Primitive Plus is in, this is how ARK should have came out initially in the first place. The reason why is just for the simple fact that in Primitive Plus, like, it's super duper, like, you know, well, it's not super duper complex, but it's a lot more complex. Whereas, like, you know, you actually have to turn your wood into lumber to build a house. You actually have to turn your clay into bricks to build a house. You know, and that's something that you have to look at. This is kind of my crop here. I'm kind of working on slowly but surely. As you guys know, without an Ankylosaurus, this is a type of dino. If you guys never seen it, check it out. But without an Ankylosaurus, it's really, really tough to gather the materials and stuff. So right now on the server that I'm playing on, we have a 2-week peace time. So if you guys are wondering why I'm putting my buildings out in the wide open like this, it's because we have a 2-week peace timer that ends on July 10th. So right now, everybody's amassing resources, getting ready for war. Because, you know, once the tides of war hit, it's pretty much indefinite until, you know, basically Alpha is, determined on the server. Then we'll establish order, which in turn, the floating island on the other side is meant to be used as a peace zone where no tribes can fight, where it's only used for trading purposes and economy order only. Okay? So with that being said, I'm going to grab some of these narco berries. Mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and make some narcotics because, like, it was so whack. Like, you guys saw my last video where I was, you know, on my way out. I was like, yeah, I had my little boat ready. I had my Rex on my raft, my level 20 Rex because I was a baller. Had my little scorpion because the scorpion just ran up on me when I was trying to leave. And I was like, oh, and it's a female, too. I need some eggs. I'm going to tame this chick. Ah, right? And then that's like, ah. And then after that, we got on the boat. And then... I crashed into, like, the end of the world, and they all fell off the boat. So, and then what happened was, the Rex, you know, first the Anki got eaten by a manta, so then we swam away. And then after that, then the Rex got eaten by a megalodon, aka shark. Fortunately, I was able to get the Rex's saddle, so I kept that. So, rip. All we had left was the Terra, which you guys see. It was the Pterodon, and that's it. Team gone. So gatherer gone, team gone. And ironically, like, I had a trike before. It was like a level 12 trike. But the Rex that I tame, like, as I was shooting him with trank arrows from a platform, like, because I solo tamed him or whatever, and he ran off, ran into my little village and my little hut before I tore it down, ate my trike, and then after I shot him again, he went down. So, you know, yeah, you know, you just been having a good time. You know, on Ark, trying to figure out what we gonna do. what are we doing with those? So that's what happened. So now here we are. You know, trying to build back up and, you know, do our thing here. You know, with our spoiled meats. And get some more narcotics here so I can start taming again, man. Start getting on the taming circuit. There's some things, like, I really want to do, like, in terms of taming is, like, right now, I'm trying to get another Ankylosaurus. So, like, dinos in this game have, like, a preferred type of food that they like to eat. And that food happens to be this thing called kibble. Now, to make kibble, it requires eggs from specific kinds of dinosaurs. So for Ankylosaurus, it requires 54 Dilo eggs. And these Dilos, if you guys seen Jurassic Park, you know, the thing, you know, I think it's Jurassic Park 2? Or maybe it was 1. 1 or 2. I think maybe it was 1. Where the little dude that spit acid, you know, ate the fat guy, that's the Dilos. So it requires eggs. Now, it requires so many eggs, it's like 55 eggs, and you need to cook this jerky. You need to turn cooked meat into jerky, and then after you turn the cooked meat into jerky, you need, like, other ingredients to make this kibble. And then once you have the kibble made, then and only then you can make this kibble, and then you have to put them down to feed them. But it's the most effective way to tame them, and it turns your tame times down into, you know, actually manageable times. Like, so to give you guys an idea, for like the maximum level Ankylosaurus, like, with on kibble, it's only a couple of hours to tame it. If you tame it on just like berries and stuff, because it's an herbivore, it literally takes like 10 hours, 12 hours, something like that. Like, real time, not in game time, like real time. Like, you're really, like, sitting there, like, looking at them, like, trying to have a conversation. I mean, you bring your ball with you, Wilson. You're talking to Wilson, like, I don't know what to do, for 12 hours. And it's crazy. I mean, it's just ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? It's just something that I don't want to do it. I'm not going to do it. It's not dealing with it. Saber toots?
No, toots.
Saber toots? Saber toots? Saber toots?
Saber toots?
Saber toots?
Saber toots?
Saber toots?
I already extinct.
No.
Mm-hmm. Grandma told me that.
They're not.
They are?
Look, they're not. Look, they're right here in the game. Yeah, I'll show you. You ready to see a saber toot?
But they're not alive in real life.
This arc is real life. So I'll give you guys a tour of the island too while we're showing these saber toots. So this island is pretty dangerous, so, like, that's why, like, it was a pain trying to get up, like, on that hill, because, like, yeah, it was just a pain, because there's, like, only one way to get up that hill, which I need to block off, so it's only accessible by flyers. But yeah, this is the island. Like, it's absolutely ridiculous. Like, I mean, that's only some of it, but I mean, there's scorpions, there's all kinds of stuff. Like, I picked this location mainly because, like, the easy tame access. The only problem with this island, I would say, is, like, Gigas spawn here. So, like, you don't know where the Gigas spawn. So, if that Gigas, like, there's a spawn point right by my house. And if a Giga happens to just spawn on top, like, especially with this being Primitive Plus and you can't make metal structures, other than, like, steel pillars, yes, it's going to be probably a bad day for me. You know what I'm saying? And we'll probably just lose everything. So, that, you know, that's that. So, this is the island here. There's stuff all on the coastline. I'm trying to find a Sabertooth. But the resources here are pretty good. I mean, we got obsidian and stuff everywhere.
I think I need it.
What I really need is carbon. Because, in Primitive Plus, like, you can farm carbon. Because you get different resources from different things there. So, you get, like, limestone from metal. You get carbon from obsidian. You get animal fat, obviously. You get bacon from pigs. You get what else have I seen? You get short ribs from certain types of dinos. I mean, you get all kinds of stuff because there's all kinds of recipes that you can cook outside of the normal stuff. And that's why I said, like, Ark should have took this format that they did for Primitive Plus for regular Ark, because I really feel like it's really awesome and it adds so much depth to the game. You know, it's not just like this basic, oh, here, we're just going to use red, yellow, and green, and blue, and then that's it. But it's really, really good. So again, like, if you guys have an opportunity to check out Primitive Plus or just come play with us, because we have a 25 pop cap on the server right now that I'm trying to max. If we need to get more slots on the server, we definitely can, especially since they're getting ready to optimize PPO anyway as downloadable content here in a month. Everything else is pretty much prepped for that, and then it'll, like, definitely reduce the load times and stuff that it takes to get in the server. You waving? Camera's right here, baby. You know, as we go through. Oh, crap, I'm out of stamina. So this is what you don't want to be doing, you know. Out of stamina on your bird, and you got a raptor and a carnival biting your butt.
I'm. You mean your pterodactyl's butt?
Yeah, they was nibbling. Nibbles. King Nibbles. King Nibbles. King.
Look at that tail.
King Nibbles, what?
Look at that tail.
The tail? What's the tail doing?
It's
so
rooting.
Anyway, what I need to do now is I need to gather wood and stone because I need to make some more handmills. I just realized I only had one handmill and I'm trying to grind out these narcotics. And the handmills are actually cheaper to craft than the mortar and pestle, right? Because the handmills is a little grinding thing that you saw. More slots on it than the mortar and pestle, and it only costs wood and stone to make. So, whereas, like, the mortar and pestle, you need high, you need stone, it's just a pain, right? So, 40 stone or 30 stone, 40 wood or something like that, 40 stone, 30 wood, something like that. But that's all it takes for the handmills. Now, the only problem is you just can't craft them on the spot, like, so they're not portable like the mortar and pestle. So, like, when you're going through the game, you know, you're flying through, you know, going to the island, you know, with Blackie here. You just can't make them on the fly, so unfortunately, you'll have to have a dino that has some kind of carrying weight capacity, or just be close to your base in order to make them. You know, so if, like, you want to craft like 10 of them or whatever, then you can get those squared away. In a video that I'm going to be doing after we get all the Ingrams and I figure out a nice little progression here for leveling in Primitive Plus, I'll talk about, like, the techniques and strategies you guys can use and the most important buildings that you can kind of put into play here for your Primitive Plus to make your life a little bit more effective. Again, like, we're on Valhalla, so, like, on the island or, like, the center, the map is quite a bit smaller, so it's really going to help to be efficient. Whereas, like, on Valhalla, unless you're up against people who know the map really, really well, I mean, the map is ginormous. Like, it's bigger than the center and the regular Ark map combined, like, and some. Like, you could probably put two island maps and the center in here, and that'll maybe fill it up. But, I mean, the map is absolutely ginormous. Like, to give you guys an idea, like, where I was at for my first base, I took a raft from there to the top of the map. And where I was at my first base was roughly about, it was close to the center. It was, like, right below the center of the map. You know, it was, like, bottom left hand, not even in the corner or anything. And it took me 1 hour and 15 minutes to get to the top right corner, like, on a boat. Like, that's a long time in a game. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the struggle is real when it takes 1 hour and 15 minutes to travel in a game. I'm just saying, the struggle is real, and I'm sorry, but that's cray cray. Okay, and now the reason you're gonna say TMT, but why didn't you just fly? Because I was on this boat and I had all my dinos and they were alive at the time. All of them, they were all sitting on the top of the ceiling, you know, because I was like, yeah, we move into the new world, Christopher Columbus style. And then they all died. And then we had this big ass boat and dead dinos. And I had a pterodon. And people was looking at me crazy, like, why you got that big ass boat for no reason? And then I asked myself, why do you have this big ass boat for no reason? And then the answer was, I don't know. Just don't know. And then that was that. So that's what happened, and that's the story, and I'm sticking to it.
Funny. And Snowy and this baby saber tooth. So are you? Cause the baby wants to see saber tooth. Her mommy.
Okay. See these issues we're running into now. My bird's overweight. He needs to go on like a diet plan. We got all this crap in here. I'm trying to like drop stuff so we can fly at like a regular speed, or at least like a slowed speed. Come on, tell me. I'm okay. All right, we're praying that we dropped enough stuff. Hold on, let me drop these berries too. That's another 6 pounds. All right, come on, come on, Lee. All right. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Jump shot. There it is. We had to, I was hoping, because a lot of times you get over encumbered. I've been investing in weight in my pterodon. I know you guys are going to judge me, but like, because most people, like when they build their terras, right, their pterodons, or pteranodon, sorry, but your terra, when people build their terras, they always go into melee damage and speed, right? Every single time. That's how everybody builds it. It's so cookie cutter. But I figure like considerable amount of time that I'm spending, because pterodons honestly are going to be usually your first like high level dinosaur tame, just because it's easy to get their eggs, it's easy to make the kibble, that they need, because that dodo kibble, and dodo kibble can be made just with cooked meat. It doesn't need to be turned to jerky or nothing, and super easy to tame. So if you can find a high level pterodon, you can get it down. You just throw a bola at it, you know, and it's done. You put it down, feed it some meat, get some narco berries or narcotics or whatever, and you know, it's easy peasy, lemon squeezy, right? And so like when you get it, most people go melee damage and speed, but I figure I'm gonna use it for a long amount of time because I don't have an Argent. I did have an Argent, but it died. It was level 20, got eaten by a Terra bird. Yeah, perils in of Ark. And but I figured he already hits hard anyway, because basically you're gonna barrel roll, and you guys have been seeing me doing like the little barrel roll and killing stuff. But I figured I'd invest in stamina and weight, right? Because the two problems you run into with the Terra is when you're barrel rolling, you run out of stamina, and the more you run out of stamina, the higher your chance is to die. So I took that, and with that being said, I was like, all right, cool. Now I'm going to just go ahead and increase my stamina so I can barrel roll more often. I can get myself out of a tight pinch and then invest in his weight. So I want to get his weight to 400. He's at 300 and some change right now. And then get his weight to 400 and then get his stamina to 3,000. And then once the stamina is at 3,000, then put the rest into movement speed and melee damage. Because either way, like if you can't put him down, can't lose kind of deal. Now, granted, there'll probably be some terrors faster than me, hit hard or whatever, blah, 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 blah. But if they miss or they mess up and they can't move and they go down, guess what time it is? Rap City time. That's what time it is. And I'm going to have that ass on the platter. Not that I'll continue using this Terra for all of eternity, but I'm just saying. But anyway, so right now I need to make some grindstone. So we're going to throw this wood on here. Boom, handmills. Let's go. Oh, we get two of them. Sweet. Boop. That's one. Boop. That's two. Alright. So now I'm gonna run over here. Hold on. I need to grab some spoiled meat. So grab two stacks. One, two. We'll go ahead and get. We need some off of him. I know he's got some. Oh, he's got 100 on him. Hey. Okay. He's got any more? He sure does. Pterodactyl.
Meat. Spoiled meat.
Pterodactyls eat meat, baby.
Just meat.
Just just meat to eat.
Not spoiled meat?
Nope, they don't eat spoiled meat. They don't eat cookies. They don't eat none of that.
Cookies?
No cookies. If you guys ask me why did I just get on the pterodon and fly over here, I have no idea.
Do dogs eat cookies?
Dogs? In this game?
Yeah.
They eat meat.
They eat cookies.
They eat meat.
They like cookies. No, they're cookies.
Blah, 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 blah.
It's meat. Cookies.
Blah.
How about cookies stuffed with meat?
What? I mean, I guess.
Will they like that?
Maybe.
They will like that.
Maybe. Maybe they will.
I want a meat cookie.
You want
cookie.
What? Meat cookie?
I want meat cookie.
Meat cookie.
Chocolate chip meat
Chocolate
cookie.
Chocolate chip meat cookie.
Ah! Snowy is sitting on the baby kitty. She farted.
Did she?
Yeah.
It stinks. You stink, Snowy.
But she's sitting on the baby kitty.
Why is she sitting on the baby kitty?
She farted.
Why? You don't like the baby kitty?
I love her.
Then why'd you fart on her?
I accidentally sat on her.
Oh.
And farted on her.
Oh, okay.
By accident.
All right. No, not on my head. Don't you toot on my head. Don't do it.
I'm just legging on it.
Alright, so what we're doing here is like I'm trying to finish this greenhouse. And like I'm trying to get these narcotics, guys. Because honestly, man, like if you guys got narcotics, man, like it makes your life a lot easier. Because narcotics are the way that you're able to tame things. Like, trust me, it is such a pain to, like, get narco berries. Because, like, when you put dinosaurs down, oh, that would have been bad. When you put dinosaurs down, there's two ways to keep them asleep. And those ways are, A, narco berries, which you get out of bushes, you got a handpick, or have a dino that's gathering those berries for you, which takes a long time. And you have this thing called torpor, right? So this torpor, as you tame a dino, depletes, right? When you knock them down, it's full. And if it depletes all the way to zero, they wake up. And it's a certain number, 2,000, 3,000, 10,000, whatever. And every single dinosaur has its own rate of depletion. So some dinosaurs like Quetzals and stuff like that deplete faster than, let's say, Megalodons, who have like a 2.5 hour torpor depletion time if they're like level 150 or whatever. But it just depends. But in order to replenish that torpidity, so your dinosaur stays asleep, they need either narco berries or they need narcotics. Now, narco berries per berry is only replenish 4 torpor, whereas one narcotic replenishes 40 torpor, which is freaking awesome. And the problem with narco berries is the more your dinosaur eats, the less effective the tame becomes, and the lower level they'll be when they come out of the tame process. So you always want to make sure that, you know, you're feeding your dino basically as little as possible. So that's where that will come into play. So also another thing is narco berries, they spoil, you know, which is a problem, because when things spoil, that creates issues. And then obviously you don't have goods, and then, you know, over time, especially if you're having a really long tame and you're having them sit on narco berries for like whatever, however amount of time, you're going to lose a lot of those berries. Whereas narcotics, they don't spoil, because the ground and basically, you know, pressed or whatever, however they make them in here, I have no idea. but as a drug smuggler, an ARC drug smuggler, you know, that's what happens. You know, you got these green narcotics that you got to make, but they do not expire, which makes your life a hell of a lot easier in this land of taming when you're trying to survive. So, yeah. So, let's get back to this tree chopping. There's these two other axes that I want to craft. I want to test and see what their damage is. But they got this battle axe. I can't remember what level. Like, the Ingram popped out. And there's this Viking axe, too, that you get to make. And I'm going to craft both of them. You can only make them on a grindstone. But I just don't have the Ingram points yet to pick up the recipes. Because I needed the sword recipe to make the one of the axes. And I need something else to make the other one, and I don't know what it is, but needless to say, that's about 100 Ingram points that I need to invest to get them. But I will get them. I will get them for you guys. just so you guys can kind of see what the difference is. So if you guys decide to start playing Primitive Plus, you guys can come in and definitely check out and actually know, I mean, what Ingrams you should buy and should not buy, especially as we move forward in this Ark game of life. So yeah, y'all. So we're just going ahead and press this out. We're trying to get all this wood. Oh yeah, I dumped the berries, so that freed up about 100 pounds of carrying capacity. So I should be able to craft at least probably 3 to 4 handmills when I get back, which would be good, because that'll kind of lock in what I need to do in terms of, you know, crafting handmills. I might be too far away to be getting experience right now, though, and that could be a problem, so I might need to hurry the hell up, because I'm missing out on narcotics experience, because every narcotics you craft, or every narcotic you craft, you get 2 XP. And that stuff adds up, you know, 100, that's 200 XP, you know, it's like half a level and stuff, you know what I'm saying? So you got to make sure. Baby, Dechamputi, why do I have this stuffed animal on my head? Does she want to be in the video?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. How long is she supposed to stay there?
Till the end.
Till for the whole video. All right. Okay. I'd like to introduce you guys to Snowy. This is Snowy. Apparently, she's staying in on my head the whole video.
I want to give Snowy a hug. There you go, Snowy.
Did she get her hug? Yes. Okay. But yeah, so I don't know. It's gonna be super interesting to see. It's, you know, cause like I said, like in the previous videos, it's so funny. Like you know, cause to play with friends and like the friends that I played with before, we were always on the same team. You know, always on the same tribe. So it's gonna be cool to see how it pans out. Cause you know, we're basically all now friends at war. You know, civil war. You know what I'm saying? Jump shot. I don't know who's Captain America. I don't know who's Iron Man. Or all those other guys, I have no idea. But we are about to find out. So, yeah. So with that being said, though, we're going to go ahead and bring this video to a close. I'm just going to go ahead and finish chopping this stone up and craft these handmills. We'll have some more stuff built for you guys to show you guys in the next video. I have no idea what my next task is. Probably taming something really big. So, yeah, so definitely stay tuned for that. We'll probably do that in the next episode, maybe we'll tame a high level Rex or something. We'll get it down so I can show you guys kind of like the process that I take in getting large dinosaurs down as I fly through this fog and hope that I'm going in the right direction. But yeah, guys, so thank you guys so much for tuning in to episode 5 of Ark Valhalla, and where we take this to the next level and crush all of the competition, hopefully. But yeah, y'all, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.